Hi everyone, so let's start the video. So today we will learn to plot a point in a Cartesian plane. So in Cartesian plane, two number line intersect each other perpendicularly. So one is horizontal and another is vertical. So horizontal line is called x-axis and vertical line is called y-axis. The two axes divides the plane into four parts. So each part is called quadrant. So 1, 2, 3, and 4 part. So this is first quadrant, and this is second quadrant, and this is third quadrant, and this is fourth quadrant. So the intersecting point, that is the common point of the two line, is called origin. So this is origin, and we know that, so any number line has an origin. And the right part of the number line is positive, and left part of the number line is negative. And this line has an origin, and if we draw a perpendicular line, then it has also an origin. So for this line, the upper portion is positive and lower portion is negative. Therefore, this line has origin and this line has also an origin. So in this situation, so both the origin of the line will be same, and the horizontal line, the right part of the horizon line, that is x-axis, is positive. We plot the positive number, and on the left side we plot the negative line, negative numbers. And similarly, upper portion of the number line, that is in here, this is called y-axis. So upper portion of the y-axis is positive. And similarly, lower portion is negative. So in one dimensional, to define a position of a number, we only need only one value. If this number line is x o x dash, or axis x o x dash, and we need only x equals to, suppose 2, only one value, 1, 2. So this is the location of the point x equals to 2. But in a plane, we need two value to locate a point, one for x-axis and another for y-axis. So x equals to 2, so only one value for the x-axis, x equals to 2. But in case of plane, we need two value for x-axis and for y-axis. Therefore, so x equals to something and y equals to, two values are needed. So we can write this pair of values in this way. So x comma y. So dx value, small x for x axis, and y for y axis. So this is called x coordinate and this value is called y coordinate. Suppose 2, 3, we take 2, 3 for example to plot this point in this Cartesian plan. Okay, first x, so x coordinate is 2, so you go 2 step on the x axis towards right side because right part is positive and here plus 2, therefore 1 and 2. Next, for y is 3, y coordinate is 3, therefore we go towards upper portion by 3 step, 1, 2, 3. So this is the location of the point 2, 3. Now suppose you have to plot -2, 3. So how can you plot this point -2, 3? So this is for x coordinate and this is for y coordinate. So x equals to -2. Therefore you should go towards left side of the x axis by 2 step, 1, 2, and then for y is 3, then you go towards upper portion by 3 step. So this is the point -2, 3. Now we are going to discuss about the sign convention of the points in fourth quadrant. So this is origin. This is origin. So what is the sign? That is positive or negative of coordinate of the point. So standard form of the point, left x comma y, small x comma y. So this point, this is x and this is this value for x axis and this for y axis. So the first quadrant, so this part touches the right part of the x axis. So this quadrant touches the right part, that is positive part of the x axis. Therefore all value for x is positive. All values for x is positive and this quadrant touches the upper part, that is positive part of the y coordinate. Therefore all values for y are positive. Therefore positive for both value. And if you discuss about the second quadrant, then the second quadrant passes the negative part, that is left part of the x axis, and this is therefore negative for x coordinate, and this part touches the upper portion, that is positive part of the y axis, and this is positive for y value. So we write therefore -, plus. So that is the form of coordinate of the point minus x comma y. And for third quadrant, this quadrant or part of the plane touches the negative part of the x-axis and positive negative part of the y-axis. Therefore, both are negative. So we can write minus x and minus y. And also for fourth quadrant, so this quadrant touches the positive part. Therefore, x is positive. And this is touches the lower part, that is negative part, for y coordinate. So this is negative. Therefore, first quadrant positive, positive, plus plus, minus plus. So this is plus plus, minus plus, because we write x for in first position and y in the second position. So we take the value x in the first position. Therefore, this is minus plus. So plus plus minus plus, and this is minus minus, and this is plus minus. So now, we will discuss the position of a point in terms of distance from the two axes. So express the position of point of a point in terms of distance from the two axes. So for example, let us take the first quadrant and take a point x comma y. So this is x on the x-axis and this is y on the y-axis. So small x, that is we go towards right part on x-axis by small x step, or if you take a numerical example, suppose 5,4, therefore we go by 5 step on x-axis towards positive direction, 1 2 3 4 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then plus 4, that is we go in upper portion, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the point, position of the point or location of the point, 5,4. Now how can you express the location of the point in terms of distance from two axes, that is from x axis and y axis? Now draw a perpendicular from this point on x axis and also y axis. So what do you mean by distance from a point on a line? So if you have to find the distance of the point from this line or distance of the line from this point, then you have to draw a perpendicular and measure it. That is, distance of the point from the line is length of the perpendicular. So length of the perpendicular drawn from the point on the line. So therefore, So distance of the point from x axis is the length of the perpendicular, this perpendicular, and also the length of the distance of the point from y axis means length of the perpendicular, this perpendicular, length of this perpendicular. So now if you see that this is a rectangle, this form a rectangle, and we know that the opposite side of a rectangles are equal, so they are parallel and also equal, and this is equals to this, this is equals to this. Therefore, so this perpendicular line is equals to the part of the x-axis, and this perpendicular is equals to the this part of the y-axis. Now so if we observe, then this part of the x-axis is the equals to phi, that is x coordinate, and this is y equals to 4, that is y coordinate is 4. Therefore this, if this portion is equals to this portion, then we can also write, so x equals to 5 and y is equals to 4, then we can write this is y equals to 4. So therefore the point 5, 4 can be expressed in terms of distance of the point from x axis is, so 5, that is x coordinate, can be expressed as distance from y axis. So 5, so this 5 is x equals to 5, which is equals to the length of this perpendicular. So we can say, so x coordinate means distance of the point from y axis. So x coordinate means distance of the point from y axis. So similarly, this is 4. So this length of the perpendicular is y equals to 4. And therefore we can say, so y coordinate is the distance of the point from x axis. Y coordinate means distance of the point from x axis. So distance of the point, distance from x axis, y, so now we are going to apply on the number on the axis. So first write what is the coordinate of the origin, what is the coordinate of the point origin. So the standard form of the point x comma y. Now x coordinate means what, distance from y axis. X coordinate means distance from y axis. So what is the distance of the origin from y axis? 0, because it is situated on the y axis. Therefore distance from y axis is 0. Similarly, so y coordinates, if you find y coordinate for origin, so y coordinate means distance from x axis. So what is the distance of the point from x axis 0, because the origin is on the x axis, therefore coordinate of the origin 0, 0, and denoted by O 0, 0, O for origin 0, 0. So what is the coordinate of the point on x axis? So x comma y. So x coordinate means distance from x axis. So distance of, sorry, the x coordinate means distance from y axis. Distance from y axis. So what is the distance from y axis? So small x, suppose small x. Therefore, we can write for x coordinate is small x. Next, y coordinate. Y coordinate means distance from x axis. Distance from x axis. So what is the distance of the point on x axis from x axis? So what is the point of the point? What is the distance of the point from x axis? What is 0? Because the distance of the point which is situated on the x axis is at the 0 distance from x axis. Therefore, so y coordinate is 0. Similarly, so therefore this point can be expressed on the left part of the number line is minus x comma 0, since x is negative on the left part. So on y axis, so we write first x coordinate. So x coordinate means distance from y axis. So what is the distance of the point from y axis? 0, because it's situated on the line y axis itself. Therefore x coordinate is 0. And next, for y coordinate, y coordinate means distance of the point from x axis. So what is the distance of this point from x axis? Small y. Therefore coordinate of the point on y axis 0, y. So therefore, we have learned that the y coordinate is 0 on x axis and x coordinate is 0 on y axis. In lower portion of this y axis, 0, -1.